Let me talk now about schools and maybe kind of give you an update on where we are. This is the most recent slide. And remember, we looked at this, I think, maybe three weeks ago now. And then we had about a third of our kids in school full-time, about a third of them totally remote, and another third that were hybrid, remote part of the week and in-person part of the week. You'll see that I think in anticipation of the vaccinations, you're starting to see these numbers change. And so this is the percentage of students. So full in-person, 376 districts, and that constitutes almost 46% of the population of our students. Go down full remote down here. That is now down to 17.6%, so it was about 33%. And then partial in-person, 36%. So we're seeing a movement away from the fully remote to either partial, the hybrid, or to more in-person. And that's a good sign. Let me talk about how the vaccination is going to take place. And we've had a couple schools that have already started. But we're really going to get started on this next week. About 500 different schools, public and private, parochial schools, charter schools, public charter schools, will be getting vaccinated. Their faculty and personnel will be getting vaccinated next week. Our goal, as we have said, is to try to get every child back in school by March 1. And if you look at our public schools, every public school is now signed except one. So, you know, we're happy with that. They've all agreed to go back in school March 1. Some of them have been in person. Some of them have been in and out based upon the situation in the community. But they've all signed that the goal is to go back March 1, all except one district. To help schools return safely to in-person education, we prioritize vaccinating the K through 12 school employees. And the goal for doing this, the reason that we're doing this, is to get kids back in school. This vaccination is available to teachers, bus drivers, cafeteria workers, custodians, anyone who's in that school building. Schools who will have access to vaccine week one have already been notified, and we have put that list out. Tomorrow, we will notify all other schools which week of the 4 weeks, which week they will actually get the vaccination. Most of them will be able to complete that in a week. Some of our larger counties, the county will not be able to totally get done in a week, and it will take 2 weeks. The plan that we will be announcing tomorrow has been created with several important factors in mind. I know people have been texting me and said, how come these other schools started? How come we haven't started? And I understand. But what I just say is that the schools and school personnel are really being put at the front of the line for the sole purpose of getting kids back in school, keeping kids in school. For all the reasons that we have talked about and how very, very important this is. So the school personnel are really will be in front of 11 or so million of their fellow Ohioans. So I know everyone wants to start next Monday, next week. We simply do not have the supplies to do that. We don't have enough vaccine to do that. We have to spread this out over that period of time. We've done all we can to make this simple for K through 12 staff to get vaccinated. They will be contacted by their local school district. This plan that we have will allow most of the K through 12 staff in a county to be vaccinated within 7 days. The goal is to make the logistics of this as easy as possible locally to maximize the capacity of local vaccination partners, those people who are doing the vaccinations. We have a limited supply of the vaccine. We pulled vaccine from our statewide allocation specifically for vaccinating our K through 12 staff. There just isn't enough to do every school in the first week. It's simply impossible.